the deck. Port calls, hit the deck.
Praise God, he's dead.
Fallon, what kind of gulag are you running here? Where's my paper? Where's my coffee? Nice clip on him, Fallon.
You're lucky you get the time of day. Boy, you think we owe you something?
You know, Fallon, the glow of your charity burns about as brightly as a birthday candle in a Band-Aid box.
Here, send a boy through Bible school.
I cursed the church before I gave her money from a snake like you.
It's cleaner in your conscience. Go on, take it.
He'll be back, MacHeath.
Hey, I'm counting on it.
Morning, Your Honor.
MacHeath.
Step away from me.
Listen, we're gonna lose this case if you don't watch your step.
Dust it off, will you? You got the item I asked for?
Yes, they're not in season here. I had one FedEx from California.
Not bad. I suppose you checked it.
Look, you're gonna end up back in jail unless you find another word. You understand?
Trust me, Mr. Merriweather.
May I assume that your night in jail has instructed you in the use of appropriate language, Counselor?
Your Honor, I learn something new with each revolution of the clock.
Well, good. Let's get started.
Excuse me, Your Honor, but I can't continue my case without free access to the necessary word.
The word itself is not objectionable. What I find objectionable, Counselor, is your flagrant and defiant use of it.
I understand, Your Honor. In that case, will the court accept the word objectionable for what Your Honor finds objectionable?
Just watch your step.
Gentlemen and ladies of the jury, as you know, I'm petitioning for damages, for compensation on the basis of the physical and mental anguish that my client has suffered due to an injury to his objections. Now, the problem that confronts me is, in a sense, a mere reflection of the problem that confronts my client. I myself have lost the liberty to use a word, whereas my client has lost the use of his objection. This is what has deprived my client of a normal and happy life. This device from hell.
What, from hell?
Designed and advertised, I quote, to offer hours of ecstatic stimulation. Not a word of warning alerted Mr. Merriweather to the hazards that awaited his objectionable. For which, at some expense, Your Honor, I've obtained this substitute.
Objection, Your Honor.
Oh, you recognize it?
Counsel, put that thing away.
If it please the court, this is only a zucchini.
That's enough, MacHeath.
Don't you like zucchini, Your Honor?
Here, court officer.
Would you prefer squash? Strike zucchini. Your Honor, if you'll just look
you're
at the
in contempt.
My client's squash. Look, Your Honor. Look. With my client. Do you want to try this thing? You want to try it?
Your Honor, I rest my case.
Look who's on the loose.
When I think about your letter to the legal grievance board,
MacHeath, why don't you go pop a maj on Parlor Wexford? Send a skateboard thief to jail. You know, if you're going to run for office, you know, you got to be in shape for these things.
Somebody ought to tighten down your carriage bolts, MacHeath.
Welcome back.
Mac, there was a homicide in Chelsea. Have you heard about it yet?
Yeah, it's too bad there's no money in it for you. It fits you to a T.
Who's on it for the Commonwealth?
Oh, justice strikes again.
This bar guy. Wait up, Jimmy.
Spoke with Troy?
Yeah, cut a check for Merriweather and send it over by messenger.
That beast who calls himself your private eye rang up to whisper drunken propositions in my ear.
Migsy?
Mm-hmm.
I think he likes you.
He calls me ugly names in public. He ignores me. I want out.
What line of business is he in?
Fish. I think it's fish.
He owns the company? You know its name? His yearly income?
I don't know.
Mrs. Giardi, I need an understanding of your husband's assets. Who does the taxes? An accountant?
Bert. I think his name is Bert.
Well, your accountant's name is Bert. That's great. What about your social life?
I haven't any. He gives me $7,000 a month.
He gives you a check and then you deposit it. He gives you cash. And he's in fish. Mrs. Giardi, let me get this straight. You're asking me to take on the mafia.
I didn't know where else to go.
Your husband will absorb my fee.
You don't know how.
I'm sure we'll get well acquainted.
Okay.
The French twins call?
No. Neither have the Swedes. Guess you've been passed over for the Nobel Prize once again. Small wonder.
Elizabeth, what's the problem here?
I have to work here. So does Tori. You wouldn't understand.
That zucchini earned this firm $100,000.
And it isn't only the zucchini.
All right, Elizabeth. So what's the story on the Chelsea homicide?
The suspect's name is Richie Littlefield. He blew up his father's car, so they put him in Acacia House, a private hospital.
That's the SOC.
Right. Run by an administrator and a shrink. Now, the administrator is saying that the incident is proof of Richie's sublimated rage or something.
Frank can't contradict him because he's dead. Does everyone agree he's dead?
Now comes the district attorney saying that Richie whacked a guy.
Any witnesses?
It's hard to say. His story is that Richie hit the guy and down he went. Now we're not getting much help from the staff.
And the prima facie supposition is anyone who's not on the staff is nuts.
Exactly. Meanwhile, well, we'll see. The kid won't talk.
What's the status on this thing?
Continue. On direct indictment.
And on the name on everyone's tongue? Doesn't dawn on anybody that I've got to pay the rent?
Well, nobody's here to twist your arm, Mac.
Go on. Go home, spend some time with Janie and the kids. I'm going to take it.
Good.
What's happening? Real bummer, huh? Hey, look, I know how you feel, but you can talk to me. I'm your attorney. Hello? Can you hear me? Hey, what are you? You nuts or what? Start. Now, can we talk? We're gonna have to enter a plea. Okay, fine. You don't want to talk? Suits me.
Guard?
Yeah. Well, what a surprise this is. Hold on.
Jimmy?
I'm here.
Turn the key on, too.
I have exactly 15 seconds.
Fine, that's more than you deserve. Listen, I just talked to the Littlefield kid. The Chelsea murder, I'm taking over for him. Delaney. So what's the deal?
Deal? Deal? Who said anything about a deal?
What, are you kidding me? The kid's nuts. You can't bring him to trial. Let me talk to Forbes.
I'm listening.
Forbes! Are we going to play ball here or what?
Where are you, Fenway Park?
No, I'm eating oysters. You want, I'll bring one over for you in my pocket.
Ooh.
Look, he's a juvenile.
He is? You're off to psychotherapist. We're going to try him as an adult.
Look, maybe he's crazy. He could be schizophrenic. What do I know? What do you know? Can we stipulate that he's crazy?
Do whatever you want to do. We're going to try him on second-degree murder. Arrivederci,
Forbes.
Sucker.
Forbes? What's going on?
Anything problem. As good as you can tell.
Excuse me, counselor.
Okay.
Delaney, never put me in a no-win situation when you know about it out front.
What's wrong?
The kid is toast. The Littlefield kid. Were you aware of that?
Mac, I can't read every file that comes across my desk.
Yeah? Well, what else did he do besides blow up his father's car and take out a shrink? Armed robbery, treason, I want it all.
The kid's a first offender. Look, I'll add him to my caseload if you want to give him back.
Hey, all right.
I didn't say that. Well, what's the story on the hospital?
Handles all sorts of things. Detox, eating problems, that sort of thing. It's a chain.
Oh, McMedicine. Great. Who runs it?
Oh, I don't know, some larger outfit, conglomerate called Centrax Limited. I think the skipper handles their account. Seems to me it used to work for him.
You have business here this morning, Counselor?
Your Honor, I'm just about to leave.
Delaney, send me a bill in the low four figures for a consultation.
Hey, Max, say hello to the skipper.
Be seated.
I'll say. There are eight of them owned by Sendrax, the skipper's client. They deal mainly in dependency disorders.
Tell me what's with the kid.
His high school counselor mentioned a behavior problem.
There's an understatement. Any drugs?
Not that I know of, but it doesn't mean he hasn't fooled around.
And this guy's name is,
Schrager. Hi, may I help you?
Yes, we're looking for Dr. Schrager.
Yes. Why don't you sit right here?
Sure. What are Schrager's credentials?
Degree from Florida State, 10-year stint at Norfolk Naval Hospital, 6 years here.
What about the stiff?
A clinical psychologist, degree from San Francisco State. Ridiculous. How do you expect to find him, Simon?
And so, it's right to be scared. Okay. But I think we're making great progress, so. Oh, Jim, would you take Rose, please, upstairs? So I'll see you tomorrow?
Okay.
Good.
Excellent.
Bye.
Bye. Hi, Dr. Schrager.
Hello, Eugene. How are you?
Dr. Schrager.
Yes. If we could just have a minute of your time. I'm sure you're still very upset about the death of Dr.
Devlin.
Oh, yes, we're all very sad about that.
Well, let me offer our condolences.
Thank you.
We'd like to take your deposition.
You'd like to... Who are you?
I'm the Littlefield boy's attorney. This is my assistant. Were you present when the doctor died?
I'm sorry, but I can't talk about that.
I've been advised against talking about this case at all. I hope you understand.
But it's all in my report. The one I filed with the police.
Of course. But, Doctor, a story loses its vitality.
Yes. Excuse me, but I have to keep these doors closed. It's for the patient's sake.
Were you there when the accident occurred?
Look, if you insist on talking about this, I'm afraid I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
Oh, Linda. So then it was an accident.
Linda?
Yes, Doctor?
Would you mind calling Ray from security and ask him to come up here, please?
I think we can tell Ray from security to take a coffee break. We've overstayed our welcome.
I didn't say it was an accident. No.
You always this nervous, Dr. Schrager?
And then I remembered. When we bought the house, he put it in my name. He said it was a wedding present from the IRS. I bought the deed.
What about the business enterprise, the fish?
It's Mr. Charity calling, Simon.
Oh, no.
Put him on! This is great.
You still in town, MacHeath?
Hey, do you use that Cadillac to drive your fish around in, or what?
Fish? I sell insurance, and it wouldn't be the world's worst idea. You buy some, huh?
I want an inventory of all your assets, and I want a copy of your tax returns.
Hey, come and get them, puffball. Who you think you're talking to, the paper boy?
He's my attorney, Al. Do you know what an attorney is?
Butt out of this, huh, Pinky?
You don't call me that!
Charity, you can answer all my questions on an interrogatory or...
You worm.
Look, the both of you should just calm down.
Watch your talk there, fat leg.
Do you call me that? I hate it! I'm sorry. Ow?
That's okay. Elizabeth? Hey, we got a case?
We have a trial date the 30th, Judge Wall.
Wall? Terrific. He was on the bench before the Inquisition. What about Wexford and Forbes? Did they say anything about a deal?
Schrager's statement has him entering a room at Acacia House and finding Witchy standing next to Devlin's body with a weapon in his hand. Here. Photographs of the deceased, the weapon, it's a chair, the coroner's report, and Schrager's too. So what's our plea?
I don't know. Maybe we can get a note from his mom.
Might have done it. Did you ever think of that, Simon?
I've been trying to get over there, but, you know, with all the kids and...
Do you think your son murdered that psychiatrist?
Well, my husband says that if the circumstances are right, that... You know, that anybody could do what Richie is.
Yeah, but he hasn't confessed.
Oh, no. Nobody could ever get a word out of Richie if he didn't want to talk.
Why do you suppose that is?
Why? You don't think your kid is going to trust his parents, do you?
Who are you talking to? Janie's crying. So, you came by. What do you want?
Just basically legal preparation. I wanted to ascertain how Richie's home life influenced his character.
Well, let me tell you something. We give him everything we could. But do you think he ever sees it?
Yeah, I understand.
You understand? You understand what? You live with him? The kid is weird. He's always been that way. He's wacko.
I see. So you thought putting him in Acacia House that might, what, unwackify him?
Yeah, I did. I figured they, could have taught him how to fit in.
Fit in with what?
Fit in with reality. Fit in with the way things are.
Yeah, I think you put your finger on it, Littlefield. I'll be seeing you.
Thanks for your hospitality.
Two more for you.
All right, over here. Come on, man.
Some music. Check it out, man. Retrovirus, Ralph, Gangrene. Come on, take it, will you? Just don't hang yourself with the headset, okay? I might get disbarred.
What do you want to
All right, Richie, this is the way it is. When we go to court on Tuesday, the DA is going to want to nail you for murdering this guy. He wants you, and he wants you bad. He's got a weapon and a witness, and he's not going to cut any deals.
I need to know what happened.
Hey, Rich. I met the folks. Golly, they're terrific, huh? I mean, your dad. Whew, he's really spun, huh? Well, I can't say I blame him, though. You did try to blow him up, didn't you? But you're no good, right, Rich? Come on, you're a killer, right? Come on, you're rotten.
I didn't try and blow him up.
What? Say what?
I put a potato in his tailpipe.
You talking to me?
Hey, you heard me.
I did hear you, Rich. I heard you. So you keep on talking. You tell me about it, Richie. You did it, huh? You're a killer, right? You're guilty, right?
Yeah.
You're a killer?
Yeah.
You're guilty, huh?
Yeah.
Then you make me see it, Rich. You describe it to me. Come on.
He was in the room.
Yeah?
What? I hit him with the chair.
Why, Rich? Why?
Because... What does it matter?
In the tailpipe, huh?
Good evening, Haverhill and Hastings.
Yeah, this is Judge Tyrone, the appellate court. Can you tell me where I can find the skipper?
He's left for the evening, Your Honor. He'll be at the Copley Plaza tonight.
Oh, thank you very much.
May I suggest the veal?
Mac.
Excuse me?
Communes well with the poulet for me. Rye whiskey straight up, warm the glass.
Oh, they seat you here, do they?
He hasn't really mellowed yet, has he? Still the prince of politesse. I suppose it's in the breeding.
Mac, for God's sake.
I believe you know my daughter.
Must have been all those long, lonely nights in the Atlantic on the Mayflower's upper deck.
Yes, you had a first-class cabin once, but you abandoned ship.
Dad!
As I recall, I was forced to walk the plank.
Exactly. Now, if you'll excuse us, Simon, thank you and goodbye.
He still thinks divorce is a capital crime.
No, I think you're a capital boor.
Oh, come on.
Forgive me. I expected we would have some peace of mind, but evidently I was wrong.
I think you both adore it.
Well, then...
Oh, by the way, I'm representing Richie Littlefield in the Devlin case. I guess we'll be in touch. Life sucks.
It's what I've always found appealing about you, Mac, your subtlety.
I didn't know you were going to be there.
And if you had? I'm glad you're such a big success, Mac.
I don't know. I got a good clientele. Make the papers every now and then. Worked out all right. Miss me?
I miss my supper.
How's the work?
Oh, picking up some basic intimacy skills?
You left me, remember?
You just don't get it, do you?
Well, look who I was working for.
That is just my point. Why can't you keep him and me separate? I can.
So funny.
What do you want, MacHeath?
Listen, I called to pass on some information about the Littlefield case. As soon as I can find an honest judge, I'm going to plead. We're going for an acquittal, Wexford.
Not guilty.
So I shouted for an orderly, and then I grabbed him, Littlefield, and I...
Now call him Richie, Dr. Shaker. Give us the impression that although the boy's a murderer, you care about him.
Of course, of course. I should know this. So I...
Funny what you find when you turn over the right rock.
We're busy here, Simon.
Skipper. Still pulling everyone's strings, I see.
I hope you understand. I pray for you.
I knew you had a heart.
I pray the MTA will hit that vulgar car you drive.
It's shriveled, but it's still a heart.
Excuse me. I'm sorry.
Oh, he's got you right in his pocket, doesn't he? You're gonna like it in there. It's dark and soft and cozy, like the toe end of a jogging shoe.
I resent the implication.
You know, you're never gonna make it to the top, Wexford. Your neck game's just not good enough.
You went to the wrong school. You're born on the wrong side of town. You divorced the wrong woman. And then there's your character. I rather think, Simon, the deck is stacked against you.
No. It's Richie the deck is stacked against.
You have a client, not a case.
I don't need your witnesses. I'll get my own. Midday. Hey, Mix. Mix, shake it off. You're taking the cure.
What for?
I'm paying you to take the cure. Come on, Mix.
Mmm, coffee, corn syrup.
Mac, you see him? God, he's huge, man.
Yeah. Well, don't worry, we'll kill it as we go ashore.
We got more of them on shore, though, Mac.
Well, I'll protect you. You're on a payroll, Migsy. Let's go. Take your medicine.
Hey, Mac. How long you been here? Mac, where are we?
This is a private hospital. I got a client who's accused of murdering a doctor there. I want you to do a workup on him, understand?
On what?
That's your assignment. Find out what happened. Get back to me. You pull this off, Migs, I'm gonna pay your dry dock fees till 1993.
Mac, you're leaving?
Call me every day, stay off the sauce, and don't blow your cover.
My cover?
Yeah, just... be yourself. Take this. This'll pay the admission. Oh, you're butt up that hill. Get your act together, Migsy. This is important.
Call that Everest a hill?
All right, Rich, let's go over it one more time. Shraker comes into the room. Devlin's laying sprawled on the floor. You're standing over him with the chair. You with me? Good. Now, tell me one thing. Who killed him?
I already told you that.
Richie, you think I haven't been around the block? You think I'm as blind as your parents? Come on. Why were you in the room? Oh, fine, fine. Keep it all to yourself. That's great. But you better get it together when we go to trial. I'm putting you on the stand. You're gonna testify.
I won't.
Well, tell me, whose testimony is gonna set you free?
What, are you afraid you're gonna lose?
Hey, I don't lose.
Well, I don't care what happens. So long as I'm away from them, I don't care.
Okay, great, Richie. You get away from them, but you got one problem. You're still stuck with you. You're gonna be 25, 30 years old. You're gonna turn around one day, Richie, and you're gonna realize something. The problem's not out there. It's here, Richie. It's right here.
What's in session? Please be seated.
Charity,
plaintiff and her counsel here, Your Honor.
Here for the defendant.
Your Honor, I've been unsuccessful at discovery. I'd like to file a motion to compel.
I'll have him sworn, and you can put your questions to the stand.
I've got a few questions, too.
Approach and raise your hand.
You can get your hand up, can't you, Al?
Mr. Chiardi, what's your line of work?
I run a business.
Import, export, agriculture, give us an idea.
It's a family business.
I don't suppose you brought last year's tax return.
Oh, no? Well, since you ask, the bottom line is 785.
Going on a million?
No, just short of $8.
Your Honor.
Answer him, you dim bulb.
I want figures, Mr. Chiardi, and I want them now. If you refuse, I can and will impose a sanction here.
So find me. Let me spend the night in jail. I'm not giving fat legs there a dime.
Well, why should you? You haven't honored any other conjugal responsibilities, have you?
What?
You do know what conjugal means, don't you?
You heard him, Al. He's right.
Hey, whoa.
It's not an uncommon problem, Mr. Chiardi. But the longer you ignore it...
Watch your step.
As any psychotherapist or plastic surgeon could inform you.
All I wanted was a little attention, Al.
You've had it, sport.
Hey, I can get it anytime I want it.
All right, let's stop this thing right here. How much you want?
How much you got? Your Honor, could I have a brief moment, please?
Just take your call. I'll see if the two parties here can't work it out.
MacHeath.
What took you so long?
All right, you got a pen ready?
Yeah. Where are you?
I'm in between group therapy and basket weaving, okay? But listen, Mac, I think I found a witness for you.
You serious?
Yeah, you got a pencil? Take this down. His name is Eugene Cisnarski. CZS. They call him the Wisher.
Wisher?
Well, how do I get with him? Like, he's a patient on the ward?
Stop holding those names. Look, I've been taking enough.
Yeah, but he's a voluntary, so it won't be any problem. Well, wait a minute. I hear Schrager calling me. Look, Mac, I got to book it. Meet us at the yacht club at the bottom of the 90 off ramp at 3:15. Got it?
Counselor! We are not finished.
McZee.
Mac. Meet Wisher. Wisher, this is my boss. Remember, I told you he might be dropping by.
It's nice to meet you, Wisher.
Thank you. That's a compliment. Excuse me, Mr. Miggs. You know it's difficult for me to listen while I'm sugaring my tea.
Here, let me do that.
That's very kind of you. Yes, I can see why you might want to work for him.
Yeah. Just say when. Now look, Wisher, I'm here to talk to you about Richie Littlefield.
Oh, yes, I remember him.
I need to know the role he played in Dr. Devlin's death. Do you recall that incident?
I'm thinking. I see some of it all right. I'll back up a little. Oh, yes, there it is. The argument. It frightened me.
Was Richie arguing?
Oh. No. I was worried about her, so I went to find him. Yes. And by the time we got there to the room...
Wait, wait. Were there people inside the room arguing?
At the time, but not when he went in. I was worried about her.
Him?
No, her.
Who's her?
Can we go home? I think I wish I was in my bed, and I wish I was watching television, and... Six. Fine. I wish you'd let me drink my tea.
Good
Thank you. Enjoy your tea.
I don't know, Mac. Doesn't sound much like evidence to me. Personally, I think you're hosed.
I wish you would go back there and find out who was arguing in that room.
I wish you would let me off this job. I need a drink.
Easy does it.
Talents fail, you fall back on luck.
I tell you, number seven still gives me the heebie-jeebies.
I think she's on our side. Trust me, it's a hunch.
You knew Dr. Devlin?
Yesterday.
Fairly well.
Extremely well. The kind of man never existed. He treated us like family.
Now, do you recognize the figure in these photographs?
Yes. That's Dr. Devlin.
Your Honor, Commonwealth's Exhibit Number 1.
Yes, show them to the jurors, please.
You said that Dr. Devlin treated you as family. Did he have one of his own?
He was divorced.
Did he ever take you to supper?
Several times.
And when did the relationship become sexual?
Objection.
All right, Counselor. You have something real to substantiate that.
I withdraw the question, Your Honor.
This is 3 South. There were several cases I wanted to discuss with him, with Max. So I walked from here to here until a patient, I'm sorry, I forget just who it was.
Oh, that's all right. That's fine.
Informed me that he saw Max go into this room here. I was in a hurry, so I just walked in.
Tell us what you saw.
Well, I saw Max. That is, his head and his shoulders. I mean, you saw the photographs. And Richie was standing next to him, and he had a chair in his hand.
Now, when you got into the room, Dr. Schrecker, what did you hear Richie say?
He said Max had deserved it.
He deserved it. He deserved it. The weapon still warm from his hand. What kind of a human being would express a thought like that?
Objection, Your Honor. It calls for speculation.
Your Honor, I suggest Dr. Schrecker's an expert witness.
Yes, I'll allow that.
Well, what we're dealing with here is more complex than the classic character disorder. Richie is an individual who has no respect for rules at all.
Is this a common trait among criminals?
Objection, Your Honor. Move to strike the question.
Question withdrawn, Your Honor. Thank you for the testimony.
Here we go. Dr. Schrager, apparently the death of Dr. Devlin took place in room 310.
Yes, that's correct.
Could you tell us who was present in the room in addition to the names you've already mentioned?
In addition to the names I've already mentioned, no one.
Well, what about a girl?
There was no girl. There was just Max, that is Dr. Devlin, and the boy.
You're absolutely sure of that?
I'm positive.
You must have checked beneath the bed.
Sir, kneeling to see if my friend was still alive, I could see under the bed.
Your Honor, I reserve the right to recall this witness when I bring my case.
You can find it, Counselor. So noted.
Dr. Schrager?
Yes, sir.
You may step down.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Maybe we should consider a plea.
Hey, you see that table right across the room there? Temperature might be a little cooler.
I can take the heat.
I know you can.
Raise your right hand.
You swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth, I'll help you God.
I do.
You may be seated.
Mr. Littlefield, your difficulties with your son go back some 8 or 9 years.
Yeah. Yes, sir. That is correct.
How would you sum them up?
I'd say he was angry, sir.
Anger. How did this anger express itself?
He'd steal. I recall a hunting knife, a high school ring. As far as acts of violence, the boy blew up my car. As a father, how do you feel about that? Wasn't there anything you could do? I coped. I was concerned, and I was shamed. I tried. I talked it over with my spouse. But all when it was said and done to no avail.
Oh, thank you.
It's all yours.
The car, Mr. Littlefield? What kind of incendiary weapon did Richie use to blow up your car? A hand grenade? A Molotov cocktail? A napalm? Kerosene? A rocket launcher.
Potato.
I'm sorry, I beg your pardon?
Potato.
A potato! Did he have a license to carry it?
Watch it, Counselor.
Excuse me, Your Honor, that really just slipped out. Isn't it true, Mr. Littlefield, that your son put a potato into the tailpipe of your car, and the tailpipe is what exploded? Isn't that true?
Yes.
Sounds more like a childhood prank than an act of criminal violence, wouldn't you say? I'm looking at your testimony. You said I coped. I was concerned. I was ashamed. I tried. Tried what? Give us an example.
I didn't spare the rod, I'll tell you that.
You mean you beat your son?
Objection. Mr. Littlefield's not on trial here, Your Honor. Richie is.
Sustained.
Did it ever occur to you, Mr. Littlefield, that what you saw as anger was really just fear?
Objection.
Sustained.
Isn't it true that you hate your son? Objection.
Sustained.
I love my son. What you are looking at is love.
No, sir, that's anger.
I love my son.
Those are the results of anger.
Counselor, I'll have you carried out in chains unless you mind the gavel.
I understand, Your Honor, and I apologize. I have no other questions.
Nothing here, Your Honor.
And this trial is recessed until the morning.
Richie, look, we got him on the run, but you gotta trust me, okay? Just talk to me.
Sure.
Oh, Simon. Let me offer you a home. Come back to Haverhill and Hastings.
Oh, we went through all that, Skipper. You and I came to blows before the ink was dry in my divorce papers.
You were the architect of all your losses then, not me. So we're all back again? This time as a senior partner?
Why now?
Oh, Don't be naive. The Acacia House is just a tile on a structure that's immense. My task, of course, is to keep it free of stress. Publicity is an example. You would know what that is.
How much does Sendrax pay you?
Pay me? No, no. Sendrax. What Sendrax offers me, Simon, is a window onto possibilities. My reward is choosing what goes through it.
Like Wexford is our next attorney general, huh?
Yes.
I hear you tendering a deal, Skipper. What's the hook?
The boy is damaged, Simon. He needs solitude. I think you ought to let him have it. Now see to it that he's offered a reduction of some sort.
What if I turn you down?
Well, the view from the top of the wall is limitless. I'd be ashamed to miss it.
So you think I forgot about you, huh? No way. Not me. Not you. Pretty good, huh? Rubies. So I'm back together with her. We're happy.
I'm grateful.
Come on by, Louise will make you dinner. And I, maybe got a little business for you, you know? You look awful. You better slow down. You're gonna have a stroke.
We're both still afloat.
Yeah. Sure.
You want it back?
The skipper made me an offer.
Oh?
The senior partnership. With access to what he called possibilities.
I'm sure it's everything you could ever hope for.
There's a hitch.
I bet.
I'd have to send a kid upriver, someone I'm defending on a murder rap. Skipper's an interested party. I tried to keep it separate, Phoebe. You, the skipper. I can't.
What'd you come by for?
I needed someone to talk to. Unless he hears the words not guilty when the clerk reads the verdict, I can't live with any of it.
Unless he hears it or unless you hear it, Mac.
You know, you have never slowed down long enough to realize that what works best is often what works easiest. Show him the person that you can't show me. Be yourself. Let him see who you are. You're not going to say goodbye?
Trying to get in touch with you all night. I must have called your number 18 times.
Look, MacHeath, I gotta put the wisher on the stand. He's all I got. He's all there is.
Mac, I got it. Oh, wait till you see this, baby. It's beautiful. Listen, I think I got a real bonus here. Now, how fast can you get out of here?
I'm on the way.
My friend, Mac.
Mac?
Julie.
Blue. Blue light.
Yeah. She talks in colors. She's candy, right? You like her? Devlin did. You want to clench her? She's trying to get away from him. The wishers across the hall, he hears their voices.
He runs and he gets Richie. He brings him back. Richie barrels through the door.
In the closet, right?
He sees Devlin spread out on the floor. And then he hears footsteps. Shraker's footsteps. Pushes Julie in the closet. Grabs the chair. He covers for her.
Where's my fee?
It was you. She killed him.
Yeah.
Look, not a prosecutor in the state would file charges here. You decked him in self-defense. You had to do it.
Silverfish.
This isn't gonna work. She's in another world. I mean, this is great, but I can't use it.
Yeah, okay, Mac. So what are you gonna do?
Swordfish.
I need a moment alone with him, please. I met the girl.
What girl?
The one that Devlin got messed up with. The one who really killed him. Julie. The one you've been taking the rap for.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Richie, if you like that girl, you know what? That's great. But you gotta stop covering up for her! It's over, Richie! You have gotta tell me the truth right now! Sit down.
All right, look. I'm going to try and share a story with you about a little kid, okay? He was a middle kid of 7. Grew up in a 5-story walk-up in Roxbury. 3 oldest kids had spent every summer in Amherst with their father. 3 youngest kids, their father lived in Hull. But every weekend, Rich, he was there to pick them up. And that left the middle kid. You see, and his mother, she'd never tell him anything about who his father was. And he had to know. So he looked for him. And he found him. One day he found him in another town with a whole nother family. He didn't know about the boy. He didn't even want to know. I understood something on that day, Richie. I can't count on anybody for anything. If I want something out of life, I gotta get it. I gotta get it by myself.
Do we have a case?
Hey, we got something. I just don't know what to call it.
D-Court, all right.
Wisher, do you know the young man at the defense table?
I'll see. Is that the defense table?
That's right.
Somebody there, all right. I think I know him. Hey, dude, it's Richie.
That's right. Richie's on trial today for allegedly hitting Dr. Devlin. Dr. Devlin died. Do you recall that day?
I'll think.
Objection.
Wexford.
He's not all there. He's not competent to testify.
I wish you wouldn't interrupt me while I'm thinking, Mr. Wexford.
Mr. Wexford, I suspect you'll have the opportunity to bring that out in cross. Go on, please.
Thank you, Your Honor. Should I restate the question for you?
No. It's there, all right. Let's see. Yes, I do recall the day Dr. Devlin died. There it is.
Good. Can you describe it for us, please?
The entire day?
No. Just the moments that preceded Dr. Devlin's death.
I wasn't sure I understood. Yes, there it is. Of course, I wish it hadn't happened.
Don't we all?
I wish I'd never seen him there with Julie.
Julie? You mean Julie Lowell. She was a patient on the ward?
That's right. And he was in the room with Julie. I wish I'd never seen what he was doing.
Just what was he doing?
He was kissing her and touching her.
You mean he was molesting her?
Objection.
I wish you wouldn't interrupt me while I'm thinking, Mr. Wexford. And I wish I would have never mentioned it to Richie. And I wish he'd never gone there to try to help her. And I wish...
Wisher, we all do. We all wish it didn't happen. I appreciate your testimony here today, and I have no further questions.
Hi, I wish. Mr. Cisnarski.
Who's the President of the United States?
President of the United States.
Mm-hmm. You know what day it is?
I'll think. I'm thinking. Monday, Tuesday, I guess I don't know. Is that important too?
I have no further questions.
Sir, you can step down now.
Commonwealth is bloodied but unbound.
Mm-hmm.
Your Honor, may I have a word with counsel at the bench?
Yes.
Are there any more?
I think it's time to plead him out, so we're going to give you a reduction.
So you can pack him off to the Department of Social Services till he's 23 instead of prison till he's 30? No, no way.
Come on, Mac. So Devlin had a thing for girls. That doesn't justify your client dusting him.
He didn't do it. Hey, what? Discuss it with him. The window stays open 1 minute.
Afraid it might shut on your hand?
The hand it shuts on may be yours, Counselor, if you don't take Mr. Wexford's offer to your client.
Your Honor, we're not taking any deals, and you can trot him back to the skipper.
What's the story?
That's what I said.
What's this girl? What's the story with her?
The girl?
I'm not.
Gentlemen,
find
out soon enough, okay?
That's enough.
The defense calls Richie Littlefield.
Clerk, would you swear in the witness, please?
Yes, Your Honor.
Remain standing. Raise your right hand.
I swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. I'll help you, God.
Yeah. No, no, you mean I do. I do.
Sit down, please. You want everyone to believe that you're guilty. Don't you, Richie?
Yes.
Let me get it straight. You're claiming that you killed Dr. Devlin.
Mm-hmm, that's right.
Well, tell us how it happened. How did Dr. Shraker come to find you in room 310? And Richie, you're under oath here.
I went to see if Julie was all right.
And then what? What happened, Rich? Come on, tell us. Richie, isn't it a fact that when you went into the room, you found Dr. Devlin dead?
You want the facts? Check the record.
Let's set the record straight, Rich. Julie killed Dr. Devlin.
I did.
You're protecting her.
You think so? How do you know? You weren't there.
You heard footsteps. You pushed her into the closet.
No.
Then you picked up the chair that Dr. Shraker saw you with when he came in. And you let him draw the obvious conclusion.
It was obvious because it was true.
You're lying.
I'm not.
Your Honor, I'm withdrawing from the case.
What?
Simon.
I quit.
Counselor, you may not leave without consulting.
I quit. The key. She was helpless. Tell us all about it.
Well, the Wisher found me in the rec room. He told me he'd heard an argument in 310. He was pretty scared, so I went back with him, and I went in the room. He was dead already. And I didn't know what to do. I heard footsteps. I pushed her in the closet. And the rest is pretty much the way he said it was.
And she never told you what he'd... what he'd done.
Just kept saying silverfish.
Say what?
Silverfish. An insect, right? She has her own language.
I suppose so. Don't we all? Look, Richie, all you're really guilty of is being afraid. Afraid of being a failure in everyone's eyes. You didn't kill him, did you?
No.
There's nothing wrong with you. You're innocent, aren't you? Thanks.
No further questions, Your Honor.
I'm sorry.
That's very moving, isn't it? Very touching. But...
Simon.
First you say you're guilty, and now you say you're not guilty, which is it?
No, not guilty.
Which you never said.
Oh, so then you were lying earlier.
He never said it was Devlin?
Yes.
Of course. Your Honor, he has no regard for the truth, and I have no further questions.
The witness may step down now.
Oh, rock and roll.
Your Honor, the defense calls Dr. Schrager. Dr. Schrager, in your previous testimony, you mentioned character disorder, and I assume you've read all the standard texts.
Well, I should hope so, yes.
The DSM-3 on diagnostic criteria.
Naturally, I've read that, yes.
Lorenz on aggression.
Certainly.
Hernandez on toxic shame.
Yes, that too.
Isn't it a fact, when you went into room 310 that afternoon, that was your second visit there, not your first?
That isn't so.
You went there for a little afternoon diversion, didn't you?
No, absolutely not.
With Julie!
Objection.
Because it was you that was molesting her.
Objection.
Not Dr. Devlin, isn't that a fact?
Now that is not only false.
Oh, is that so? You went in there, and he found you. He found you out, didn't he? And then you killed him.
God, that's a lie.
You sat outside that room, and you waited for Richie Littlefield to wander in. And then you set him up, huh? Oh, you got him, you framed him!
Sir, I'm concerned about you. You're delusional.
I'm delusional?
Yes, you're insane.
I'm insane! Hey, Doc, I got a little news flash for you. If I'm insane...
Simon!
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Someone get a doctor.
Oh, my God.
Simon?
I'm a doctor. Excuse me. Please back off.
Give him some air.
Hold on.
Hold on.
Silver fish.
Right. Hey, Doc. Hmm. Let me ask you something. Tell me, Doc. How did Julie come to have this in her face?
Sure.
This tie tack. The shiny marlin.
Silverfish.
Julie? What?
Your Honor, I rest my case.
Counselor, that's quite a performance. Court officer, detain Dr. Schrager.
Man who calls himself a private eye insisted I tell you Richie's found a place near Harvard Square. He's living with a house full of musicians.
Mixy?
No, the boy.
Who's the guy in white?
He claims the IRS is harassing him, the patriarch of something called the Church of Sam and Betty.
Dust him off.
He said he would pay $10,000 for the consultation.
Why do I always get the nuts?
New revisions on Ochoa. Appellate court tomorrow, Jones. You've read the cases?
Yeah, in the meantime, what? The Church of Sam and Betty? Isn't there a CIA scandal or some petrochemical disaster?
There's a
woman in the powder room. She said she had to see you, but she wouldn't leave her name.
Wouldn't leave her name? What are we talking, Greta Garbo here? I recognize her?
They all look alike. That's for you.
Hey, thanks.
Don't mention it.
Don't worry. Elizabeth, send that lady in. It's always a divorce.
You busy?
Who, me?
If you haven't met Charlene, Marlene, and Darlene, well, drop by their apartment this Thursday and find out why the Washington Post says they are funny. Catch Babes right after The Simpsons. And tomorrow night, a sure thing comes once in a lifetime, but the real thing lasts forever. John Cusack stars in a Rob Reiner comedy, The Sure Thing, tomorrow on Fox Night at the Movies.